Hello everyone, today in this video lecture we are going to discuss about de novo synthesis of the fatty acids. De novo synthesis of the fatty acid occurs in the mostly liver, kidney, adipose tissues, lactating mammary gland. The enzyme which are located into cytosomal fraction of the cell, so it is called as extra mitochondrial or cytoplasmic fatty acid synthesis system. The major fatty acid which is synthesized by the de novo pathway, that is the palmitic acid, which contain the 16 carbon saturated fatty acid. The synthesis of the fatty acid which are mostly occur in the liver, then kidney, adipose tissue and lactating mammary gland. The most of the enzyme which are located into the cytosomal fractions. The major fatty acids they are synthesized, that is the palmitic acid, which is the 16 carbon number long chain fatty acid. The acetyl coenzyme, that is the source of the carbon atoms. NADPH provides the reducing equivalence, that is NADPH, that is produced from the HMP shunt in the carbohydrate metabolism and the malic enzyme reaction. The every molecule of the acetyl coenzyme A delivered to the cytoplasm, one molecule of the NADPH, that is the foam, and the ATP supplies the energy. Then the pathway of the fatty acid synthesis, the acetyl coenzyme A, that is the source of the carbon atoms, and NADPH that provide the reducing equivalents. The NADPH that produce in the HMP shunt and the malic enzyme reaction. The every molecule of the acetyl coenzyme A delivered to the cytoplasm, and one molecule of the NADPH that is the formed during this reaction, and ATP which supplies the energy. The stages of the fatty acid synthesis. The first step, that is this production of the acetyl coenzyme A and NADPH. Second reaction, that is the conversion of the acetyl coenzyme A to malonyl coenzyme A. The third reaction, that is the reaction of fatty acid synthesis complex. The three stage for the synthesis of the fatty acid. The first step, production of the acetyl coenzyme A and the NADPH. The acetyl coenzyme A, that is starting material for the de novo synthesis of the fatty acid. The acetyl coenzyme A, which is produced in the mitochondria by the oxidation of pyruvate fatty acids, degradation of the carbon skeleton of amino acid, and also from the ketone bodies. The mitochondria, they are not permeable to acetyl coenzyme A. So, by the alternate pathway or the bypass arrangement, it is made for the transfer acetyl coenzyme A to the cytosol. The acetyl coenzyme A, that is the starting material for the synthesis of fatty acid. This acetyl coenzyme A produced in the mitochondria by the oxidation of fatty acid, pyruvate, degradation of carbon skeleton, amino acids and the ketone bodies. The mitochondria, they are not permeable to acetyl coenzyme A. So by the alternate pathway, the acetyl coenzyme A, which is transferred to the cytosol. The first acetyl coenzyme condenses with the oxaloacetate in the mitochondria to form the citrate. This citrate that is freely transported to the cytosol by the tricarboxylic acid transporter system. In cytosol, the citrate is cleaved by the ATP citrate lyase to liberate acetyl coenzyme A and the oxaloacetate. This oxaloacetate in the cytosol is converted to the malate. The malic enzyme convert the malate to pyruvate. The NADPH and the carbon dioxide, they are generated in this reaction and both utilize in the formation of the fatty acid synthesis. The reaction, that is the acetyl coenzyme A, which is condensed with the oxaloacetate in the mitochondria and gives the citrate. Now this citrate that is freely transferred to the cytosol by the TCA transporter system. In the cytosol, the ATP citrate lyase enzyme that liberates the acetyl coenzyme A in the oxaloacetate. This oxaloacetate in the cytosol converted into the malate. After the malic enzyme that convert the malate into the pyruvate. In this reaction, NADPH and the carbon dioxide, they are generated and both are utilized in the fatty acid synthesis. The transfer of the acetyl coenzyme A from the mitochondria to cytosol pathway. In that, the mitochondria, the acetyl coenzyme A that is formed from the pyruvate, amino acid, fatty acid. By that, the acetyl coenzyme A converted into the oxaloacetate with the help of citrate synthase, which gives the citrate. This citrate is transferred to the cytosol with the help of TCA transporter. In the cytosol, the citrate converted into the acetyl coenzyme A and the oxaloacetate. The oxaloacetate further converted into the malate and the with the help of malic enzyme converted into the pyruvate. During this reaction, NADPH and the carbon dioxide is formed and utilized for the synthesis of the fatty acid. The advantages of the coupled transport of the acetyl coenzyme A and NADPH. The transport of the acetyl coenzyme A from the mitochondria to cytosol, that is coupled with the cytosomal production with the NADPH and the carbon dioxide, which is highly advantageous to the cell for the optimum synthesis of the fatty acids. The NADPH and the carbon dioxide that generate into this reaction, which are utilized for the synthesis of the fatty acids. So when the reaction, in this reaction, NADPH and the carbon dioxide form, which is utilized for the reaction in the synthesis of fatty acid, which is optimum level. Next, formation of the malolyl coenzyme A. Acetyl coenzyme A is carboxylated to malolyl coenzyme A by the enzyme acetyl coenzyme A carboxylase. This is an ATP dependent reaction and requires the biotin for the carbon dioxide fixation. The acetyl coenzyme A, which transferred to the cytosol, now that is converted into the malolyl coenzyme A by the carboxylate reaction, and the enzyme that is the acetyl coenzyme A carboxylate. For this reaction, the ATP gives the energy and require the biotin for the fixation. The mechanism of the action of the acetyl coenzyme A carboxylase similar to the pyruvate carboxylase, and the acetyl coenzyme A carboxylase enzyme that is the regulatory enzyme for the synthesis of the fatty acid. Here is the reaction of the acetyl coenzyme which is converted into the malolyl coenzyme A. The acetyl coenzyme A, in the presence of the acetyl coenzyme carboxylase and the biotin, that is converted into the malolyl coenzyme A. Reaction of the fatty acid synthase complex. The fatty acid synthase, that is the multifunctional enzyme complex in the eukaryotic cell. The fatty acid synthesis exists as a dimer with the two identical units. That means the fatty acid synthesis complex, that is the dimer complex, the two monomer units which is present in the complex. Each monomer possesses the activity of the seven different enzyme and also having the acyl carrier protein, that is the ACP, bound to the 4-phosphopentathine. The fatty acid synthesis function as a single unit catalyzing all these seven reactions. Advantages of the multi-enzyme complex. The intermediate of the reaction can easily react with the active site of the whole enzyme. The advantages of this multi-enzyme, that is the intermediate which is formed during this reaction, can easily interact with the active sites. The one gene code for the whole enzyme. The whole enzyme, they are the equimolar concentration. So, the efficiency of this process is enhanced. The enzyme, they are the present in the fatty acid synthesis complex, they are the equimolar concentration. So, the efficiency of this process, that is the enhanced. Fatty acid synthesis complex. The first domain or the called as a condensing unit. It is the initial substrate binding site. The enzyme which is involved in this complex, that is the beta-ketoacylase synthase or the condensing enzyme, the acetyl transferase enzyme and the malolyl transacylase enzyme. These three enzymes which is present in the first domain, that is the condensing unit. The second domain, that is the reduction unit, it contains the dehydratase, then the enolyl reductase, beta-ketoacyl reductase and the acyl carrier protein. The acyl carrier protein, that is the polypeptide chain having the phosphopentathene group to which acyl group they attach in the thioester linkage, and the SAP, they act as a coenzyme A carrying fatty acyl groups. So this is the second domain which is also known as the reduction unit. Next, third domain, that is also known as the releasing unit. They release the fatty acid in the cytosol. The major fatty acid which is synthesized, that is the palmitic acid, and it contains the thioesters or the deacylase. That means the third domain that contains the thioesterase enzyme or the deacylase enzyme. The reactions of the fatty acid synthesis. In this reaction, two carbon fragment of the acetyl coenzyme A that is transferred to the ACPO of the fatty acid synthesis complex. The catalyzed by the enzyme, that is the acetyl coenzyme A ACP transacylase. The first in the reaction, that is the two carbon fragments from the acetyl coenzyme A which is transferred to the acyl carrier protein of fatty acid synthesis complex. The catalyzed by the reaction, the enzyme, that is the acetyl coenzyme A ACP transacylase. The acetyl unit is then transferred from the ACP to the cysteine residue of the enzyme. So the ACP site forms the vacant. The enzyme malolyl coenzyme A ACP transacylase, they transfer the malonate from the malolyl coenzyme A to bind to the ACP. The acetyl unit attached to the cysteine then transfer to the malonyl group. That means malonyl group that is attached to the ACP, the acetyl unit that is attached to the cysteine. The acetyl unit which is attached to the cysteine moiety, they transfer to the malonyl group which is bound to the ACP. The malonyl moiety loses the carbon dioxide and added by the acetyl coenzyme A carboxylase. The carbon dioxide which never incorporated into the fatty acid carbon chain. The decarboxylation, that is by loss of the energy which is allowed to reaction proceed forward. The catalyzed by the beta-ketoacyl ACP synthase, the beta-ketoacyl ACP reductase reduce the ketoacyl group to hydroxyacyl group. The reducing equivalents, they are supplied by the NADPH. Beta-hydroxyacyl ACP undergo the dehydration. A molecule of the water that is the eliminated and the double bond that is introduced between the alpha and beta carbon of the chain. A A second NAD pH dependent reduction, it is catalyzed by the enol ACP reductase, occurs to produce the acyl ACP. The four carbon unit which is attached to the ACP, that is the butyl group. The carbon chain which is attached to the ACP is transferred to the cysteine residue. The reaction of the malonyl coenzyme ACP transacylase and the enol ACP reductase, they are repeated with the 6 more times. The each time, that is the fatty acid chain lengthened by the 2 carbon unit. The carbon chain which is attached to the acyl carrier protein transferred towards the cysteine residues. The reaction of the malonyl coenzyme A, ACP transacylase and the enol ACP reductase are repeated more 6 times. The each time, the fatty acid chain lengthened by the 2 carbon unit. At the end of the 7th cycle, the fatty acid synthesis is completed and the 16 carbon, that is the fully saturated fatty acid, that is the palmitate, bound to the ACP. The enzyme palmitate thioesterase separate the palmitate from fatty acid synthesis and complete synthesis of the palmitate. Here is the pathway of the de novo synthesis of the fatty acid. In this reaction, acetyl coenzyme A, that the acetyl group that is attached to the ACP of the FAS complex, the reaction that is catalyzed by the acetyl coenzyme A, ACP transacylase, the ACP attached with the acetyl moiety. Now the transfer of the acetyl group, that is towards the cysteine moiety. The next malonyl coenzyme A, they transfer the malonyl group to the acetyl S enzyme, that means the ACP of the enzyme. The cysteine contains the acetyl moiety and the ACP which contains the malonyl group. The reaction catalyzed by the malonyl coenzyme A, ACP transacylase, and the product, that is the acyl malonyl enzyme. The next, with the help of ketoacyl ACP synthase, the ketoacyl ACP complex is formed. That means the cysteine moiety which transfer its acetyl moiety to the ACP with the malonyl. The next, beta ketoacyl ACP, that is converted into the ACP hydroxyl acyl ACP with the help of ketoacyl ACP reductase. In this reaction, the reducing equivalent is utilized by the NADH. Next, the removal of the water molecule, the alpha and beta carbon, they form the double bond, so it is known as the transenol ACP. The next, that is the by using of the NADPH, the transenol ACP, that is converted into the acyl ACP. Next, the transfer of this carbon chain, that is the from ACP to the cysteine moiety, and the reaction from the second to the sixth, that means second step, that is the transfer of the malonyl group to the ACP, and the sixth reaction, the repeated with the 6 more times. In the end of the 7th cycle, the palmitoyl, that is the formed, and the that is the 16 carbon saturated fatty acid form, and the help of the palmitoyl thioesterase, the palmitate carbon 16 carbon number chain, they are released by the thioesterase enzyme. Fatty acid synthesis complex. It is a multi enzyme complex. The fatty acid synthase, that is the dimer, H unit, that is the monomer unit, and the having the molecular weight, that is the 240,000. The each subunit contains the activities of the 7 enzyme and the SFP with the phosphopentathine group. The two subunits lie with the antiparallel orientation. Here is the structure of the fatty acid synthase multi-enzyme complex. In this, the various activities of the enzyme, that first ketoacyl synthase, then acetyl transacylase, maryl transacylase, dehydratase, enol reductase, ketoacyl reductase, and the ACP, that is the attached with the thioesterase and the phosphopentathine group. Here is the two subunit. Each subunit contains the 7 activities of the enzyme. Significance of the FAS complex. The FAS complex offers the great efficiency, that is the free from the interference of the cellular reaction for the synthesis of the fatty acids. That means FAS complex that contains the 7 activities of the enzyme, so it has the great efficiency, which free from the any other interference which is occurs in the cellular reactions. There is a good coordination in the synthesis of the whole enzyme in the FAS complex. The regulation of the fatty acid synthesis. The fatty acid production that is controlled by the enzyme, metabolites, products, hormones, and the dietary manipulations. The first acetyl coenzyme carboxylase. This enzyme controls the committed step in the fatty acid synthesis. The first reaction in the fatty acid synthesis, the acetyl coenzyme carboxylase, which is utilized in the reaction, so it controls the committed step in the fatty acid synthesis. The acetyl coenzyme carboxylate exists as an inactive or the active polymer. The citrate promotes the polymer formation and increase the fatty acid synthesis. The palmitoyl coenzyme and the maryl coenzyme cause the depolymerization of the enzyme, inhibit the fatty acid synthesis. The acetyl coenzyme carboxylase, they active in the they exist in the inactive form as well as the active form. The citrate that promotes the polymer formation and increase the fatty acid synthesis. And palmitoyl coenzyme A and the maryl coenzyme A cause the depolarization, so they inhibit the fatty acid synthesis. Next, hormonal influence. Hormones that regulate the acetyl coenzyme carboxylase by the separate mechanism, that is the phosphorylation and the dephosphorylation of the enzyme. The phosphorylation, that is the inactive form of the enzyme, and dephosphorylation, that is the active form of the enzyme. The hormones, that are glucagon, epinephrine, norepinephrine, that inactivate the enzyme by cyclic AMP dependent phosphorylation. And the insulin, that dephosphorylate and activate the enzyme. The insulin that promote the fatty acid synthesis, while the glucagon that inhibit the fatty acid synthesis. Insulin stimulate the tissue uptake of the glucose and convert the pyruvate to the acetyl coenzyme. This also facilitate the fatty acid formation. The consumption of the high carbohydrate or the fat free diet increases the synthesis of the acetyl coenzyme carboxylase and fatty acid synthesis, which promote the fatty acid formation. The fasting or the high fat diet decreases the fatty acid production by reducing the synthesis of acetyl coenzyme carboxylase in the FAS, that is the fatty acid synthesis complex. Next, availability of the NADPH. The reducing equivalents for the fatty acid synthesis are provided by the NADPH, which comes either from the citrate transporter or the HMP shunt. about 50 to 60% of the NADPH obtained from the HMP sand, which influences the fatty acid synthesis. That means availability of the NADPH, which also affect the fatty acid synthesis. The fatty NADPH that is utilized in the fatty acid synthesis, they are comes from the HMP sand and the citrate transporter. The only 50 to 60% of the NADPH which is obtained from the HMP sand. Thank you.